I'm seeing Harry Styles today.
That sentence that's actually leaving my mouth.
Where do we even begin, besties? Oh my God. Okay, where do we even begin with this story? Let's take it from the beginning. As we all know, I got into Harry Styles when it was quarantine. And basically, I have became a massive fan. Also with One Direction as well. So, we all know that's where it started. Now, did I think in any expectation I was going to see him this year? Not even a single chance did I think I was going to be seeing him today. Oh, besties. I was so wrong about that. I have all my stuff packed over there. My phone is charging. My other camera battery is charging. I got my rings on and I got my nails did, and I'm going to be putting fake tattoos on. Yes, I'm going that crazy for Harry. Me and Rima have been going back and forth with like, okay, we'll buy these tickets next week. Oh, like we'll buy these in 2 weeks. Oh, like let's make sure that these prices go down and blah, 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 blah. I basically did a Caitlyn Ray, we'll say, and I did impulsive decisions, baby. And that's what's happening. So I got these tickets off of SeatGeek. They were in my Access account yesterday. And it's actually happening, and it's not hitting me, and it's not gonna hit me until I probably start hearing da 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 da, and I see the fucking bunnies on the screen. And then a few people from my Pittsburgh Louis group chat is also coming, and I'm excited to see them, and I'm excited to go and scream my lungs out, but also go and be safe, but also probably cry a million tears. And then from there, we're gonna go. We got an Uber to take us to Cleveland. This is my first concert back in 2 years, and my last show was Shawn Mendes, and now this one is Harry. And bitch, I'm not ready. And I already made one TikTok. I'm gonna have 1600 fucking more, and I'm gonna annoy the shit out of my friends. I am going to show you the TikTok I sent to majority of my friends who don't like Harry like I do. Because it was the perfect one. I saved this for a long time, and it's there.
Where is that picture at?
It's St. Patrick's Day.
We really don't give a fuck. It's not a major holiday.
It's really not. Bitch, you act like it's fucking Damn. Christmas or something. Fuck you and St. Patrick.
Alright, it's been a little bit later. I have the tattoos on. I had some on like my sides over my hands here, but then they rubbed off some on my wrists. And then I have the tattoos right here. Thought I could switch it up and do that. Got the jewelry on. I got an H. If everyone remembers like a Fashion Nova haul I did, there was an H and I just painted it black with nail polish to match my pink and black outfit that I'm wearing. I kind of just styled my hair a little bit, and then I'm going to curl it once I get to Rima's. It's just in pigtails for now because I really wanted to try that look. I brushed my hair out.
I'm at Rima's house. This is why my hair looks like this.
Wait, did you see that? Look at the top of my hair.
It's like in that one Christmas movie, The Grinch.
Cindy Lou Who?
The Who's, yeah.
So anyway, I'm getting ready. I am curling my hair. I'm curling it, and then it's in pigtails, so that's why like I have it up, and I clearly don't have anything, and I'm wearing a fine line hoodie, and I was also playing One Direction, and Harry just posted a tradition, we'll call it, with his MSG shows. So we're doing pretty well over here, I would say. Yeah.
Should we just search romantic comedies on Netflix and then see what we find?
Thank you.
can get into any Rocket Mortgage deal house in Chicago, where you can explain your dream of having a penthouse.
We're currently in line for merch. I'm with Emmy. She's from my group chat. And then Rima's over there. We had a lot of conversations in line about tattoos.
We got featured in a TikTok. This girl asked us to be in her TikTok. It's like the trend where like everybody wears the same pair of glasses and some shit.
I'm living my best life. This is what I waited for. I did a Caitlin Ray thing. She gets pretzels all the time. I'm excited.
So excited.
We're in the same building as Harry Styles.
We're breathing the same air as Harry Styles. Yay!
After we ate and we went to our seats, and Harry has a pre-show playlist that he plays like every time before he goes on stage, like before Jenny Lewis came out and everything. And this was the song that came up. And everybody in that arena pretty much knew what that song was. Which is amazing. Moment, which I love how the whole arena, and when I say the whole arena knew this song, and this is a moment I pretty much waited for a long time, so I was happy.
To see the things you mean to me, oh, I love you, I love you, I love, love, love Olivia.
Came the moment we all waited for, Harry to come out, me to hear Golden, me to cry. It's a whole moment. Enjoy.
Thank you.
couple of things about the show. First of all, two things. As you can see, tonight's show will be in the round. We'll be in the middle of you the entire evening. Okay? This means two things. One, some of the time I'll be facing you, you'll be looking at my face. Right? Some of the time I won't be facing you, you'll be looking at my ass. Rump. If you have a preference, please feel free to make it known. And I've seen you two sitting there. I'm gonna bring you some rump.
This
Justin before we get to this next clip. So this next clip is him performing Lights Up. For some reason, this was my favorite performance of the night. And it was Lights Up of all the songs. Like, I don't know why, but like the vibe in the room with Lights Up was just amazing and everything. And I don't know why that was my favorite performance of the night, but it was. There was just something about it, you know? So, yeah, I just have to preference that. I don't know. There was something in the room and the vibe. If you were at the Cleveland show, then, you know, maybe some type of vibe was in the room that made Lights Up like one of the best performances of that night. So that's just my thing. So, yeah.
I love being on the stage.
stage. It's my favorite thing to do. I want to be here with you. So thank you. From this side, I'm here to this side. Thank you, God. Every single one of you here tonight, thank you so much. Everything you did to be able to be here tonight, I appreciate it. I appreciate you for allowing me and us to be on the stage. Thank you.
Back at this footage and editing it for the first time, how am I supposed to be okay and go out through my day when I hear shit like that? Like,
I'm not okay.
Then proceeds like to sing Fine Line after this, which makes me want to cry even more.
Please make some noise for Miss Edith Sandler!
I'm trying to comprehend how that that actually happened. I'm still trying to comprehend how that happened.
It happened. Well, we did it.
2 years. And we finally made it. My camera is currently balancing on a setting spray and a perfume bottle. So, we love DIYs, but make it broke edition. So, I wanted to wait a few days to basically comprehend everything that happened 2 days ago. And tell you my final thoughts. First of all, if you're a fan of Heyyy and you've been wanting to see him, go and fucking send it and do it. I did this opportunity because I wanted to see him more than anything in the world, and he was my number one person that helped me out of quarantine and helped me with a loss I went through and through the littlest things. And his music is just very healing, and I just wanted to experience that live, and I did. I literally sobbed to Fine Line, like majority of people in maybe that arena did. To hear Golden live, I cried as well, because Golden is my other favorite song off of Fine Line, but also to hear Kiwi.
Chef's kiss.
The second thing I want to mention is the people I met. I met two people from my Louis Tomlinson group chat I'm a part of on Twitter. Emmy and Sean, and literally wonderful people, wonderful ass people. Emmy, love her. She stayed with me and Rima up until like the showtime, and we met in a merch line literally outside of the arena, and she was so sweet and she is so kind, and I now have her number and I have her Snapchat now, so we're pretty much gonna be talking about everything until I see her again in February for Louis' show. Second thing, I met a TikTok legend, which is Sean. Sean is a TikTok legend, and I absolutely adore them. They are on my For You page constantly, and icon, legend. All I gotta say, icon and legend. And I did see them earlier when I was walking up to one of the signs, but I didn't want to say hi because I was too nervous and scared. So there's that, but literally icon, legend. And then some of the other people that I came across in just like in the merch line or in like the seats or just like getting into the arena, a lot of the people were so nice. That's just Heyyy's fandom. A lot of them that you could see at a shows do not make you feel alone and truly are the sweetest people ever, and that's his brand. Treat people with kindness, that is his brand, and it definitely shows in the people that go to his shows. And then getting home out of the arena, oh, that was definitely something. We had to take Ubers there and back, which was
a lot of fucking money.
You know, it was something. Did I fall asleep in the Uber? Yes. Was the guy very kind and nice? Of course. Thank God I had an AirPod, that way I can listen to music when that's happening. I also have to hurry this up because my camera battery is flashing currently. But yeah, some Uber situation I had, I wanted to mention super quickly, but you know, also happy I have a reliable friend. My friend Ken, I'm gonna send him the link to this video even though he does not give a shit about Heyyy. Did not think anybody was up in a group chat that we have with our other friend Eliza. And those were the people I was texting at the time because it was midnight / almost 1 a.m. at that time when I was getting a solo ride home. The guy offered me a ride home after we dropped Rima off, and I was like, okay. So we put my address in, we went, I was listening to music, we were talking, but you know, just because, and we also stopped at a gas station, and I basically was texting my group chat, Ken happened to be up, and yeah, he just talked to me during the whole ride, which I appreciate, but the thing that we were talking about, the moment I got in that Uber to go home, I found out Heyyy may or may not be part of a Marvel movie. And Ken is a Marvel fanatic. Like, besides my other friends, Liz, Andrew, and Stacy, Ken is the other person in my life that adores Marvel movies, and he can literally talk about it for hours. I don't understand it, but then again, I feel as that he gets how I feel about Heyyy and One Direction. He was talking to me about that the whole time. Interesting conversation about Heyyy potentially being Thor's brother. So, that was my night, but honestly, it was probably such an amazing concert, and if you have the opportunity to go and see him, I say fucking do it. It's like midway during tour right now. I think he has a show in like Mohegan Sun tonight, and yeah, it's amazing, and I'm probably never gonna forget it. And this is the first to many shows I'm going to, and yeah, I'm excited to get this back because this was taken away from us 2 years ago, and the fact that we're finally getting it back under safety precautions, obviously, it's definitely something. Also, before the camera battery dies, if you're wondering, I got merch. I got a tour shirt. Those tour dates on the back. Got these treat people with kindness hair ties. I got like three of them. One's in my head right now because it's a hair tie, not a bracelet. I got a tote bag for my friend Michaela. Gonna send Michaela the link to this video. That way she knows I got it. My feather boa is still in here. Good quality of a bag, by the way. Got a treat people with kindness water bottle. And then I have, if I can make this quick, I have Heyyy on my wall now. And he is next to Ariana and Sean. So I love that. It just says Heyyy Styles Love on Tour 2021, Cleveland, Rockin' Mortgage Fieldhouse, October 18th. But I'm happy for concerts to come back, and I'm happy that we get to do this again, but under a safety precaution. But yeah, I love it. I think it's great. And yeah, but if you guys like this video and you want to see more content with like concerts and pop culture related stuff, let me know by giving this video a thumbs up, subscribe, turn bell notification, that way you know when I upload. And I'm happy to be back. I'm happy I went to the show. I feel so good. And yeah, and like Heyyy says, we'll be all right. So we'll be all right.